Misha really only has one rule around here. Don't get caught.
Bother, that's just garbage. I talk.
Welcome home, boss. The digs are yours now. Hope you like the look. Culver had some peculiar tastes. But this view is something, huh? Everything you see here is under your control now that you're in charge.
I still don't get it. Why put me in charge?
You may have noticed that our former overboss, Coulter, was a fucking asshole. And that's me being nice. Ended up being poison for this whole operation. The way I see it, surviving the gauntlet means you've got what it takes. Or at least the potential. For a good while now, we've needed someone who can get shit done, make real progress.
I sure do like the sound of that.
I thought you might. Look, I'll be honest with you. This operation needs someone to step in and take the reins. Sure as hell ain't gonna be me. Leading outright ain't my style. And there's already some blaming me for supporting Coulter all this time. My talents are best put to use helping a new overboss get all this shit under control. You get me?
What sort of talents would you say you have, Gage?
Aside from being a good shot and having a foul mouth, I've run with gangs nearly my whole life. I know how raiders think, what they're after, and how to use that to your advantage. Trust me, I'm in this just as much as you are. This shit needs to work out.
Oh, sure. I understand. So, are you just gonna paint the bullseye directly on my back, or what?
I ain't gonna lie. It's a part of the reason you won't see me stepping up and running things. But I'm telling you, it ain't gonna be that bad. Let's take a step back and talk big picture, okay? Nuka World. Shit. This was the dream. Huge. Built like a goddamn fortress. You run this, world is yours. We had a good head start on it. A lot of work went into getting the disciples, the operators, and the pack to work together. But we got here. About a year ago, we push in through the front gate. Take over Nuka Town. Get these traitors under our thumb. And then, well, Coulter got lazy. He was content to sit on his ass. Never bothered putting in the effort to finish taking over the park. The gangs got restless and started pissing each other off. It was... is... a real mess.
What kind of a mess am I walking into here?
It was little shit at first. Heated tempers, arguments, the occasional shooting. Got worse over time, though. Gangs started staking out as much territory as they could. All being on top of each other like this. Started looking for excuses to turn on each other. If something ain't done soon to settle things down, it's gonna reach a point there ain't no coming back from.
I can fix this. I can make this work.
Yeah? Man, I sure hope so. You know, I've heard about you. In charge of the Minutemen, ain't you? No idea why you'd waste your time with those has-beens. I ain't no genius, but as far as I'm concerned, history already proved what they're after ain't gonna work. Look, I know these gangs. Been working with them or against them for years now. I'll help you, okay? Walk you through everything. First thing you gotta do is get the gangs behind you. Without them supporting you, you're not getting shit done. You don't have to trust them. Hell, you don't even have to like them. but you need them to respect you enough to follow you.
Have any advice for how I should go about it?
Yeah.
All right. The disciples like violence. The bloodier, the better. Tell them they'll get plenty of it. The operators are in it mostly for the money. They get promised caps, they'll listen to you. The pack, hell, I don't know. They follow whoever they think is the strongest. Show some teeth, I guess.
Don't worry. Everybody likes me.
Yeah, I wouldn't count on that. Look, technically, you're already the new overboss, right? That's like half the work done right there. Just meet the leaders. Talk with them. Flex your muscles a little. Show them you mean business.
What happens after they're on my side?
Then, we get started on taking over the rest of Nuka World. But one step at a time. You in?
Okay. Let's do this.
All right. That's what I'm talking about. You just need to show them you're the right woman for the job. I'll be here if you need me. You are the overboss after all. Just don't screw this up.
Aren't you raiders all the same?
Hey, come on now. No need to be insulting. Commonwealth gangs, well, most of them don't even qualify. They ain't organized. They don't make smart decisions. Basically one step up from rabid animals. I've run with some of them over the years. Every single time, they either think way too small or get themselves wiped out. I make a point of getting the hell out of Dodge before that happens.
I don't get it, Gage. What's the appeal of all this?
Oh, come on. It ain't that hard to see. You take whatever you want from whoever you want. Anybody has a problem with that, you cut them down. You telling me that doesn't sound like even just a little bit of fun to you? Anyway, don't mistake the gangs out here for being the same as those Commonwealth saps. Gangs out here, they got agendas. And they're gonna expect results. You can't afford to forget that. You need anything else?
I want to know more about Nuka World.
Yeah, good call. Big time amusement park back before the world went to shit. Well, I guess if this place is any indication, it wasn't so hot before it all blew up. Anyway, we weren't the first to think of this place as a good stronghold. Before we got here, a bunch of traders had set up shop. Hired a whole lot of guns to protect them. They were dug in like ticks. That's why it took pulling a bunch of gangs together to even have a chance.
You've got this area of the park. Isn't that enough? Why do you want more?
You got a lot to learn, boss. So we've got Nuka Town. And most of the traders work for us now. They ain't happy about it, but screw them. We really need the rest of these parks, though. Every one of them not under our control is a threat. And the gangs are too cramped up. They're stepping all over each other. Unless they get room to spread out, there's gonna be bloodshed. So the sooner you get them all to agree to follow orders, the sooner we can improve our situation. You got any more questions?
Tell me more about the gangs.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, quite the assorted bunch. All used to hate each other, and I guess maybe they still do to a degree. Took a shitload of work to get them all on board with this idea, so I really don't want to lose them now. If I were you, I'd start with the disciples. They might all be crazy, probably are in fact, but Nisha has her reasonable moments. Then you've got the operators. Spoiled, rich kids. But doesn't mean they ain't ruthless killers. If you can impress Mags, she'll listen to you. And then there's the pack. I'm not saying they're savages, but, well, shit, they're savages. I don't know how Mason keeps them on a leash. Up to you who you want to trust the most, but you're gonna need to trust at least some of them. You need anything else?
Nothing else for now.
All right. You know where to find me.
Gage?
You need something, boss?
Nothing else for now.
All right. You know where to find me.
Watch yourself, boss. Because we sure will be.
Hey.
If you come across any Hobologist crazies, just ignore them. Told those freaks to stick to their camp.
Come on, girl. You know we should run this place. Not some little greenie Gage dragged in.
We're giving him a second chance. Gage screws this up, he knows we'll skin him alive. So shut up and be patient.
What about you, big guy? Nothing to say on the matter?
As long as she doesn't get in my way, don't much care.
Yeah, figured as much.
Both of you just get out of here. And make sure the others get the message.
Don't look like much to me. You want to talk? Talk to Nisha.
Hey there.
So, you're Gage's little pet project.
Pet project? What's that supposed to mean?
Gage didn't say anything. Apparently, we're not good enough to run this place ourselves. Gage wanted to bring in his own little puppy to replace Coulter. But I guess training a puppy is way easier than getting us to do what he wants.
And what are you?
His grandma?
If I was, I would have slit that little suck-up's throat a long time ago. Gage will never be one of us. He's a failure. He's lucky we're giving him a second chance. Everyone knows we all wanted Coulter dead. Of course, if I had my way, it would have been a slow, painful process. But whatever. Let's get this meet and greet over with. I'm Nisha. I lead the Disciples. We've only got one rule around here, and that's keeping the peace of this alliance. Otherwise, the way we see it, this world stopped caring about rules the moment people started dropping bombs on one another.
I bet you guys are great at parties.
Side with us, you'll soon find out. Just don't slack off when it comes to actually doing your job. We got Coulter Nuketown. And suddenly, he forgot the big picture. We both know how that turned out. Although, I could give him a little credit. He built the gauntlet, after all. Of course, it was total shit at first. No imagination. But we spiced it up a bit.
Hey, I thought it was pretty impressive.
Good to see the new boss at least has some taste. I might let you keep that head on your shoulders after all. Let's just hope Gage is right about you. He made a lot of promises to get us here. Never followed through. So you better not screw this up, because I'm not about to tolerate another round of bullshit.
Are you questioning me? Your overboss?
Not questioning. Just curious. We were wrong about Coulter. We won't make the same mistake twice.
I'm the best there is.
Willing to bet your life on that? You see, the Disciples don't make empty threats. We make good on them. We aren't swayed by caps like those spoiled brats obsessed with their hair, or those savage animals who can't behave in public. Fuck this up, and I will kill you. Although, I admit I have even better plans for Gage. But, if you support us and keep your promises like a good little overboss, we back you. You get to live, and everybody wins.
I don't make promises.
and you'll do what I say.
Looks like you're already a step above Coulter. We'll see how this plays out. For now. But if you change your tune and decide to play nice, there's no shortage of work around here. So, if you're looking to prove you've got what it takes, you know where to find me.
Hey,
looking a little bored there, boss. I got just the thing to cure that.
I'm listening.
I think it's about time the Pack learned a few lessons. They recruited some ally out in the Commonwealth. But you know how bad it can be out there. Most people don't live very long.
Who are we talking about here?
Some worthless local raiders.
I hope you're not under the impression I'd do this for nothing.
You are the overboss, aren't you?
Sounds fun.
That's what I like to hear.
Master of storytelling.
You may run new.
Mags and William normally have me frisk visitors, but you get special treatment. Sorry, Mags. All anyone's turned up so far is that she's got that pit boy on her arm.
So, our new overboss is a vault dweller.
Or ice the vault dweller.
You can go.
Why bother? That's just garbage. I toss it.
Hey.
Well, I suppose we all owe you for putting down Coulter.
Man was an idiot. It has all looked bad.
A clown stuck in his own little car. I guess we can take some solace in the fact that someone finally gave him what he deserved. I want to know, what did you feel as you did it? When you brought that walking pile of human garbage to his knees?
Taking down an opponent like that, it's thrilling.
Sure looked it.
Perhaps you're better suited to this than I expected. Regardless, Gage's decree means that you're the new overboss. I suppose we can only hope you work out better than the last one. I'm Mags. This is my brother, William.
Pleasure.
Along with our co-conspirator, Lizzie, we run this crew. Call ourselves the Operators. You'll come to understand soon enough that we are the only gang you should be backing around here. Because we're the only ones who see this place for what it is. A temple. A testament to the only thing that matters in this world.
Making money?
Exactly. Caps. This place was built for the sole purpose of taking caps out of the pockets of fools. We only joined Gage and Coulter's little menagerie in order to restore it to that goal. Though by somewhat more cutthroat methods than I expect its founders intended.
Instead, Coulter had us sitting on our asses for the better part of a year while he lived large in his damn mountaintop.
And that means, if you're going to be in charge around here, we'd like some assurances that you intend to bring this place back to its true purpose. And that we're going to get back to robbing folks of their fucking money.
Actually, I'm really more in this for the soda.
Great. Another nut.
William, Of course, Overboss. So, you're welcome in the parlor whenever you like. Make yourself at home. And if you think you might be interested in running some jobs for us, you just come speak to me. But do take a little time to consider the kind of life we could all have if we put this place back to doing what it does best.
Mags always saw the potential in this place, and she doesn't steer us wrong.
Hey, Overboss. Operators could use your skills if you've got some time.
Whatever I can do to help.
Good. Seems an exchange of goods hasn't gone over as planned. You'd be there to ensure our people come out on top.
Who am I up against?
Just some Brotherhood irritants.
I expect you to make it worth my while.
We're no charity. Good work will be compensated.
Think I'm gonna enjoy that.
Was hoping that's what you'd say. Watch yourself out there.
Any operator gets caught breaking the peace, I'll punish them myself, boss. Can't let them think it's all right to get caught.
William.
Should be a couple odd jobs available if you want to get your hands dirty. Talk to Mags.
Mason's been waiting for you.
Feathered the last alphas. Ain't been seen since. And it ain't smart to go asking about it.
If you're wearing a collar, it's because you asked for it. Ain't no one's a slave that don't want it. There's plenty of collars in the kennels, if you can.
If you can take something, it's yours.
Now that I get a closer look at you, I'm not sure I'm buying this game over, boss.
You gonna be a problem I need to solve?
Slow down there, boss lady. We're just getting to know each other. Name's Mason, the Pax Alpha. This here's our side of town. You might be overboss, for now, but I'm the boss of the pack. And it's gonna stay that way. Long as you don't go forgetting that, we're gonna be fine.
Your people aren't gonna cause me any problems, are they?
The pack does what I tell them. You don't get in my way, they won't get in yours.
The pack? Fitting. You smell like animals.
Ah, never heard that one before. Look, it ain't like anyone's broke up about Coulter. Just figured on his replacement being, well, different. But Gage says you're the boss now, so you're the boss.
You don't want to be overboss.
If I thought the other gangs would go along, yeah, I'd run this place in a heartbeat. Might have to, if you turn out to be a turd. At least it ain't Mags Black, that freak Nisha. Besides, you can't possibly be worse than Coulter.
Coulter was weak. Why'd you follow him at all?
Been wondering that ourselves. Don't get me wrong, Coulter was definitely overboss. Not a man to mess with. And things were good in the beginning. Real good. But that was a year ago. Then Coulter went soft. Wanted to take stock in what we achieved.
So what is it you want?
Caps, action, something! Anything that's more than the sitting around we've been doing for the last year.
I'm listening.
Sure, this place beats living in the shitholes we had out there. But it ain't the palace of caps we signed up for. Ain't none of us happy. Not even the disciples. and they're normally a chipper bunch so long as they're drenched in blood. Things were going to hell fast, but Gage put the brakes on that, got us together, and promised he'd find someone to deal with Coulter.
So, what's the real story behind Gage and Coulter?
Hey, I only know what I've heard. Story is that Gage talked Coulter into becoming overboss. And he got you in here, didn't he? Maybe he likes people owing him. Maybe it lets him get things done without getting dirt on his hands. After Coulter went soft, Gage got us behind closed doors and promised he'd get someone to off Coulter. And you did just that. Might have been the whole point of the gauntlet all along.
I trust we're done with the history lesson?
Yeah, boss. Just trying to fill you in on why we're all so pissed off. Look, let's cut to the chase. You're gonna do right by the pack. I hear you've been talking to the other gang.
What's the pack got over the other gangs?
The pack are the meanest sons of bitches you'll ever meet. We do whatever it takes, and we're fiercely loyal. The operators will cut your throat as soon as they get what they want out of you. And the disciples, who the fuck knows what those crazy bitches want? There's something wrong with them. You can't trust someone who ain't willing to show you their face.
Be a good dog and do what you're told, or you'll be put down.
Oh, yeah, boss. Not in front of my guys, all right? You got enough to worry about without a dominant struggle inside the pack to deal with. You know what? I think we're not so different, me and you. I want you to have this. Consider it a token of our mutual understanding and respect. One last thing before I let you go. There's always work to do around here, keeping the zoo in order. If you're ever able to lend a hand, drop by. Loyalty's a two-way street.
Hey there.
So nice of you to drop by and check in. Care to lend a hand?
What you got?
Or cause a little ruckus for our so-called friends, the disciples. They got a patron in the Commonwealth who's been funding them. I'd like to redistribute some wealth. Go fetch me that patron. I want you to call her. Sneak up on her or beat her into submission. Either way, you should be able to slap it on her without much fuss.
Who are we talking about here?
A nobody. Should be easy for you.
I hope you're not under the impression I'd do this for nothing.
The rules of the pack. You help chase down the prey, you share in the spoils. So yeah, you'll get some.
Sign me up.
That's what I like to hear.
Informational assistant?
That's right! Just stop by whenever you have a question about any of our world-famous attractions. If you're looking to take a break, I can point you to one of our family-friendly restaurants or the non-stop thrills of the Nuka-cade. Now, before you set off on your grand Nuka adventure, let me tell you about... Error. System malfunction.
Are you finished wasting my time, you filthy low-life scabber? Because I'm getting bored, and when I get bored, I get violent.
You are clearly suffering from some kind of major malfunction.
The only malfunction I've got is this idiot scabber standing in front of me. Maybe I should solve my little problem permanently.
System restored. Oops! Sorry about that little glitch. Data logs indicate unauthorized tampering with my personality subroutines. Please contact a Nuka World maintenance technician as soon as possible.
What happened? Who was tampering with you?
I wish I could say! The personnel involved do not match visual records of any known Nuka World employees. Fortunately, my audio receptors recorded the entire event, and I submitted a holotape per standard security procedures. Now don't you worry, even despite that unfortunate incident, I'm still operating at well over 61% normal capacity. As I was about to say, I have a little tip to help you make the most of your exciting Nuka World adventure. Be sure to collect park medallions as you enjoy our amazing rides and attractions. There's a special reward if you collect a full set. If you have any questions about Nuka World, I'd be delighted to answer them. And remember, any time is the right time to enjoy a cold, refreshing Nuka Cola.
What if I want a place to relax or get a bite to eat? Where should I go?
Why, you're already here. Nukatown, USA is a great place to unwind and enjoy a delicious meal. If you're searching for a tasty treat your kids will love, take the whole family to Cappy's Cafe. Looking for a romantic night out? Enjoy dinner and a show at the parlor. Want a commanding view while you enjoy a world-class dining experience? Head on up to the Fizz Top Grill on Fizz Top Mountain. If you're up for a challenge, test your skills at the Nukacade, or take a wild ride in one of our cola cars. What else would you like to know?
Tell me more about these park medallions.
I'd be delighted to. Spread throughout the park are several dispensing machines that will give you a special park medallion. Once you've got a complete set, just bring them back to me for a special reward.
Where can I find these dispensing machines?
I'll give you a hint. You'll want to visit some of our most popular rides and attractions to find them. What else would you like to know?
Tell me about the different areas of the park.
With pleasure. Set a course for the stars in the galactic zone and see the amazing future of mankind's journey into space. Explore Starport Nuka and blast into adventure aboard the Nuka Galaxy roller coaster. Travel back in time to Dry Rock Gulch, where you can walk the dusty streets of a frontier town. See history come to life in our authentic reenactments of cowboys and gunslingers as they tame the Wild West. Witness the wonder of nature in Safari Adventure, home to an amazing collection of exotic animals from all over the world. Challenge the hedge maze and climb the towering treehouse, where you'll enjoy a commanding view of our magnificent menagerie. Be sure to visit Kitty Kingdom, a magical realm where fantasy meets fun for the whole family. Your younger tykes will love to go for a spin on the giant Ferris wheel, and be sure to take a tour of King Cola's castle. Finally, in celebration of its worldwide debut, we've revamped the World of Refreshment ride to feature a river of Nuka Cola Quantum. What else would you like to know?
No questions for now.
In that case, thanks for... error. System malfunction.
You're still here? Get the hell out of my face, you miserable, dung-sniffing dirt scratcher!
System restored. Have a great day!
The Overboss returned. Yeah, you're back in one piece. That's a good sign. Everything all peachy with our friendly neighborhood psychopath? Sure hope you didn't promise them too much. I mean, going a little over the top is part of the game, but you don't want them holding it against you if you can't deliver.
All the gangs are on board.
I knew you had it in you. Time to roll up your sleeves, boss. There's work to be done. This place is huge, divided up into sections, parks, whatever the hell they called them back in the day. We need to take them all back, one at a time. Every section we secure gives us a little more breathing room and more resources. You stake a claim, plant a little flag for one of the gangs, and that settles it. It's theirs for good. Who gets what, that'll be your call. Whoever you hand it off to will appreciate it, but the others might get a little jealous. You know how it goes.
Plant a flag. Are you serious?
Dead serious. Look, you leave it up to anyone else, the gangs will all just fight over who deserves the space. A lot of these idiots can't read, so it needs to be as plain as day for them to get on board. They know what to watch for. So that's it. Nice and simple, right? Take a minute. Settle in if you want. And then let's get to it. And hey, we're in this together, so I might as well go all in. You want me watching your back? You just say the word.
Why? What's in it for you?
For the love of... Ain't you been listening? I'm the one that sold this whole idea to the gangs. Shit goes south. It ain't just your head they're gonna want on a stick. I like my head where it is. So if I can do anything to help keep it there, I'm gonna. So, what's it gonna be? We doing this together or not?
That sounds like a great idea, Gage. You got a deal.
You're the overboss.
Hey.
What's up, boss?